sense. So if you're the opposite of your child, we're going to talk about this in just a minute. If you're the opposite of your child, so whether you're the organized one and they're not, or vice versa, the methods that you use with them have to make sense to them, which obviously means some of them aren't going to make sense to you because it's what works for them. And the same is going to hold true when we're talking about those with learning challenges. Because if you are basically, for example, a highly visual person, and you've got someone who takes in information mostly in an auditory or kinesthetic way, it's going to be very different what works for them than what works for you. And it's really hard. I know it's one of the first things we learn as organizers, is that just because my system of filing my papers as an adult works does not mean that it's going to work for everybody in here. But guess what? We all have the same kind of papers as adults. You know, we got something about where we live, we got something about our medical condition, we've got, you know, credit cards, and we've got saving and checking, and all that. We all have the same kind of papers. But how we're going to file them is going to be different. Not that there aren't going to be some in common, but how we're going to file it is going to be a little bit different for everybody, and it's the same with children. Student must participate in the process. Okay, I can tell you multiple stories of adults who have challenges around organizing, and one of the challenges is they feel like they have to keep everything, because when they were young, I'm not going to look at anybody, their parents went in and would gather stuff up and remove it, and they would come home and there would be stuff missing. And they were very frustrated by that. And it's because they didn't get to participate in the process. So that's a huge piece of it. And of course the systems should fit the needs and the personality. So that's one of those things where, you know, if we're looking at, for example, I know someone brought up, you know, that what if someone doesn't want to be organized, doesn't have the desire? Okay. Not everybody's going to. There are some people that really don't mind living in clutter. Now, for those like me and my staff who are all organized, we don't quite understand it. We work with it every day, but we don't quite understand people who like a more extreme amount of clutter. So that means that if you have a child that has that, you might not quite understand it either. But that's where it goes back to expectations. The expectation is that if you're a member of this household, you know, in the common areas, things need to be put away in your room, and you discuss what that looks like in your room. One of the hardest things as adults is that we assume that children know what we mean. So when you say, go clean up your room, what does that mean? I mean, if you ask them what, they may not know. I mean, to them, maybe it just means the floor is clean, and therefore, if everything is pushed under the bed and the floor is clean, it's clean. And you're going, but everything's under the bed, you know? But they don't know that. To them, clean means that there's nothing else on the floor. So a lot of it is really discovering what that is.